I know I've got to post all day today, but what's going on?
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Epcot. We're live this morning, guys. I'm here for opening day of Epcot's International Festival of the Holidays. And it's a beautiful morning this morning. The park is a little bit crazy. Not only is it opening day of Festival of the Holidays, but it's also Mickey Mouse's 90th birthday today, guys. So Epcot is a little bit crazy. But thank you all so much for joining us. Like I said, we are live here in Epcot, and we're going to go around this morning and check out the beginning of the Festival of the Holidays. So check out some of the new merchandise, maybe check out some of the food menus offered. And guys, we're going to go meet Mickey Mouse this morning and tell him happy birthday for his 90th birthday. So I hope all of you guys are excited for a fun morning here in Epcot. And I can see all you guys in the chat. Arjons, JB, Nick, Magical News Live, welcome. Samantha, DPC Dad, Archangel, Caroline, John, Samantha, Bob, Jeffrey, all of you guys, welcome to the stream. Sherry, Disney Circus Girl, thank you guys so much for joining. And we are going to have a great time. Guys, let's take a second and go over here really quick and check out what's going on over here. It's button day, guys. Any special events, you know what special events mean. Special events mean button day. So let's come over and see what's going on with the buttons.
Let's go, Krista!
I know what's going on with the buttons, but I'm going to let you guys see what's going on with the buttons. And here it is, guys. Look at all of them. These are happy birthday Mickey buttons. 90 years old today. Isn't that amazing? Can I grab a couple of them? Thank you so much. Check it out, guys. All right, we're going to have to do a giveaway later on and give away a button or two, because I just grabbed three of them. How awesome is that, guys? I'm going to pack them in my pockets. There it is. Anyone want to do a screenshot for Mickey's 90th birthday? I can't even tell from here. It's too bright. Yeah, Mickey buttons, guys. How awesome is that for the 90th birthday celebration today? And it's Festival of the Holidays, so that's amazing. All right, well, before we get too far, guys, kind of got ahead of myself. I wanted to get out of the craziness there in the beginning of the park. I am not here alone today. No, I am not. I'm here with Stephanie.
Hello, everyone. How are you?
Everyone say hi to Steph. We're excited. The weather's amazing out here.
It is so nice. It's not that typical Florida, you know, hot and sunny. It's still sunny, but it's only in the 60s right now. I think it's warming up to high 70s.
Yeah, so it'll be perfect. Great. Perfect to go around and try out some of this delicious food, which we will not be doing on the live stream. I'll talk a little bit more about that in a second. But we're going to have fun this morning. Let's go check out some of the merchandise. Park just opened at 9, so people are just starting to flood in. Let's go check out.
What?
Oh, you already got it?
Yeah.
How's it going? Where did this come from?
I already got it.
Oh, you already went in and then came back
yeah.
over? Marshmallow Man's here too, guys. Check it out. Check out. He already picked up the magnet. So this is the pass holder magnet, the Goofy one. We are ahead of ourselves today. We already got a magnet. But we'll have to go wait in line and get one too. They're giving them these over here in
Mouse Gear.
In Mouse Gear. Oh, okay.
Man, that was crazy.
All right, guys.
Wait, actually,
everyone's saying hi, Steph. There is a little bit of everything going on here today, guys. Hope you're excited. Sorry, I'm gonna get back to the chat now, guys. We've been running around, Mickey Mouse, happy birthday. Cupcake. I just saw the cupcake on there. How cool is that? Good morning, how are you? All right, guys, listen, things have been a little bit crazy getting in here this morning. So I'm going to hand you guys over to Stephanie because I need to take just a 2-second break Couldn't make it before we got into the park, so I'm going to hand you over to Steph.
Oop, hold on. I was not mentally prepared for this. There we go.
Hold that. Don't let it fall. There you go. And hold right here.
Alrighty, can we walk? Alrighty. Well, you guys are mine for the taking right now, so we'll do a little bit of walking and just so we have a better view. Cory will be back in just a minute. So how's everyone doing today? Oh, it is so nice here in the shade. It's our own little winter. Hey, Magical News Live, how you doing? I am really excited to check out all this merchandise. As Cory knows, I like to do the shopping. Hey, Dennis, how are you? Hey, Samantha. DPC Dad in the stream, how are you doing today? Yes, it is winter for us. Winter where we can still get away wearing shorts, but it's definitely cooler than usual. Mickey Mouse, are we excited about the 90th birthday? We are super excited. Cory and I both have on our Mickey Mouse shirts today. And I am pretty sure they're going to have some nice desserts here for us to try, so I'm excited about that. David, how are you doing? Hi, Finn. Sawyer, leaving in a week for Disney. How exciting. Let's take a look back at the globe as we wait for Cory to come back and join us. I don't want to get too far. We try not to play hide and seek too much. Oh, I see Cory off in the distance, so he'll be here in just a moment. So in terms of merchandise, stuff I am looking forward to seeing today. Coffee mugs are always a big thing in our house, so Cory likes to collect those. Sunset Travels, let's see your shirt. Well, Cory's about to join me. He actually has the Christmas one on, so I will show that off. It's not for the festival, just a holiday one. I'm going to show off your shirt. We were just discussing them. Hold on.
I had to wear a Mickey shirt on Mickey's 90th birthday.
Here we go.
But it's a Santa Mickey. Or not really a Santa Mickey, just a Christmas Mickey shirt. I like it. Show me your shirt?
No, not yet. We were just discussing shirts as you showed up. I'm going to hand you guys back off to Cory one moment. Sorry if it gets a little wobbly for a moment. DPC Dad, I'll definitely keep you in the know to let you know how those shirts feel.
All right, I'm back, guys. Let's check out Steph's shirt.
My Mickey shirt for today.
I like her Mickey shirt. I like the red shirt.
It's nice and bright. I even have my Mickey necklace on to celebrate the birthday.
Awesome.
All righty, so let's go check out
the
merchandise.
Thank you, Trevor. Yeah, let's go, guys. Come on. Hey, Super Bowl champions. Welcome to the stream. Ashley, welcome. All right, guys, we're going to go check out some merchandise now. Not only merchandise here for the Festival of the Holidays, but also we'll see what merchandise they have for the 90th anniversary of Mickey Mouse as well. Or 90th birthday. I'm sorry. Yeah, Mark, happy birthday, Mickey. Oh, thank you so much, Super Bowl champions. Hey, guys. So, we're going to go check out Mouse Gears, or go into Mouse Gear and check out some of the merchandise they have in there. I don't know where in the world Steph went. She's back behind me. But, for the weather, like Steph was saying, the weather is really nice here today. Only like right now, like in the 60s, and gonna be in the mid to high 70s, I think is the high. So it should be really, really good. Oh, Mickey does look nice for his age. He does look really, really good. Oh, this is the line for the magnets, guys, but this is the line for the magnets.
Yeah, you want to get the magnet?
We might as well just go ahead and get it. Okay. All right, guys, we're going to go ahead and get our magnets. No, Craig, I do not think there is a festival center for the holiday festival. At least I haven't seen anything about it. I need to grab one of the maps and just make sure, but I do not believe so. Yeah, Nick, I know it lags, so I want to get to the festival merchandise is usually over by the other entrance. So I'm going to try our best to get over there to see it. So we'll see. I might need to go around and go out to go see it. You know where it usually is, over by the other entrance coming in from over by Test Track. But we'll go ahead and get our magnets first. Lil Marker, welcome. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, Pluto in the sweater is cool, isn't he? Look at all these magnets. Thank you very much.
Hello.
Awesome, guys, we got it. So there is the Goofy magnet. So this is the first time Goofy has been on one of these magnets. And we love these magnets. Refrigerator. I really like the Goofy one. You know, it's Christmassy or it's wintry. It's got the snowflake. I was saying that it gets a little laggy in here. So we're going to walk around and come in on the other entrance where I know the merchandise is for the festival. And we'll go check it out that way. Yeah, thanks, Nick. Yeah, we're gonna jump around and go this way.
Where's that music coming from?
Yeah, we were just at Mouse Gear, so we're gonna go back in. We're just going around to the other side. It's a little bit laggy in that store. So we're gonna come around to the side where I'm pretty sure they have the festival merchandise. And we'll be checking out the festival merchandise out around the World Showcase too. Thank you. right, guys, I hope you enjoyed just stopping by and checking out a little bit of that. I always love it. During Food and Wine, they were like playing pots and pans, and they had little stoves that they pushed around, which is really cool. That'll wake you up, Steph, right? So as you can see, guys, like I said, it is a beautiful morning out here this morning. The sky is nice and crystal clear, blue skies. Ready for a fun morning and day here at the opening day of Festival of the Holidays. And like I said, the World Showcase opens at 11, and the plan today is to do a stream this morning, just take you guys around, just to take in the morning festivities and check out the merchandise that's offered for the festival. It's also the morning of Mickey's 90th birthday. And then we're going to be doing a full vlog here today. So when we end the stream, we'll start going around the World Showcase, trying out some of the food items, and then we'll get that vlog out to you guys for opening day here and let you know what we tried and what was good. Hey, Rob, welcome to the stream. How's it going? All right. So here's some of the Christmas merchandise, guys, which we've just checked out recently. We're doing the...
Oh my goodness. This is so soft. Check out this blanket.
Oh, isn't that cool?
That is amazing.
For $60.
I know, but it is so cute.
$59.99 for a throw.
Awesome.
But it is cool. I agree. This is some of just the merchandise that they have in a lot of the resorts and parks for Christmas. And I'm looking for the festival specific merchandise. It's a little plate for Festival of the Holidays. Not for food use. Well, that is interesting, guys. Check this. Check this out. I'm like, oh, it's a little plate, right? Look at the sticker that's on here. Not for food use. Food consumed from this vessel may be harmful. What? What does that even mean?
Maybe it's a soap dish.
Let's see. It doesn't say what it's supposed to be, but I guess it's got to be a soap dish, right? Don't try and eat any food off of it, guys. What the heck's going to happen if you try and eat food off of this thing? It's kind of scary. I know, Rob. Steph's right. It must be a soap dish. I mean, would that make sense? So $12.99 for a plate that you can't use. I know. What the heck? You could put candles on it. Yeah, I guess. And so check out here is the apron for $29.99. And you can see it has the festival logo. And then all the countries. That's pretty cool. Yeah, probably lead, guys. I don't know. That's crazy. I don't think they would be using lead, but this is actually a pretty cool apron. Here's another throw. Okay, yeah, here's the Festival of the Holidays one. And this one's only $39, so $20 less.
And this is more like fleece. It's actually a lot softer. So cute.
Yeah, it's the Chip and Dale. A lot of the merchandise for this festival is Chip and Dale. And that one's really cool. 40 by 60. Very neat.
Okay, you gotta come check this out. Look at the Chip and Dale nutcrackers. They're so cute.
That one is really neat.
I don't want to shadow it because you're right in the sun here.
Yeah, we're gonna have to flip them up to see them. So here is... This is Chip, and the sun is actually really bad right here, but there you go, guys. So here's Chip, and look how big these are. I mean, these are big nutcrackers, and you can see his name down there. He's standing on a stump.
If you had a mantle, like, over a fireplace, these would look amazing.
They would be perfect, yeah. And so there's Chip, and here's Dale. Yeah, those are really, really neat nutcrackers, aren't they? How cool is that? So how much are they?
Uh-oh, moment of truth. You see it?
Yep, they are $54.99 a piece. But yeah, they're big and they're really, really neat. Yeah, that's true, Rob. You can only use them for part of the year, so shouldn't they be cheaper? And so here's that's some of the cute pins, the limited release pin for the Festival of the Holidays. Chip and Dale. I love it. For $14.99. Yes, they are nutcrackers, Rob.
Want to go check
a lot of, ooh, there's the mug. I always like seeing the mug, guys. It's a little bit busy in here, man. We're kind of like pushing and pulling. What is this? This is a cookie jar?
It's a cookie jar.
A cookie jar.
Let's see.
Cookie stroll. The holiday cookie stroll.
$19.99.
$19.99,
yeah. It doesn't have that Disney feel to it, though. Aside from basically the Mickey head on the other side of it.
Yeah,
because really
these are just like cookies, you know.
Yeah, I mean, that's like your only Mickey on the entire thing.
Yeah.
I don't know about this one.
It's still cool, but...
No, this is cool.
All right. Guys, I love the mugs. And here is the Festival of the Holiday mug. Ripley, thanks for the subscribing. I appreciate that. Welcome to the channel. So here is... I know the lighting's really bad. Oh, here we go. There is the Festival of the Holidays coffee mug. 2018. Oh, I couldn't see what it said on the other side. It says, have a delightful holiday season. Tea... Delightful holiday season. Yeah, Rob, is it suitable for cookies? Can you actually put real cookies in it? And this is $15.99. And this mug is hand wash only, which is interesting. A lot of the coffee mugs here at Disney are, you know, dishwasher safe, but this mug is hand wash only.
I like this one. Only a dollar more than the one you were looking at.
So this is more of a travel mug, but it's still ceramic for $16.99.
It's cute.
And this one has, there it goes. This one has Chip and Dale. And it's nice too, but I have a, here, pull that off real quick.
You got the cup. There we go.
Yeah. Yeah, see, I was just looking at one of these at Disney Springs the other night. They come to like a cone on the inside. I don't know how much liquid you could actually fit in this, but it's not very much.
What is that plug on the bottom?
I don't know.
It's a little just, strange.
I didn't like it. It's kind of weird. Alright, yeah, so that's, I'm not in love with any of those mugs. Is there anything else
ornaments
over here that we miss? Oh, yeah, let's go over here. Excuse me. Alright guys, so here is some of the merchandise for Mickey's 90th, so we're kind of looking between both of them. Oh, we just got a super chat from Patrick for $2. Good morning from Boise, Idaho. Welcome, Patrick. Thank you so much for that super chat. I really appreciate it. Everyone put hearts in the stream for Patrick. Thank you so much. So like I said, we're looking through merchandise that's not only for the Festival of the Holidays, but also for Mickey's 90th birthday, which is today. And check out this birthday cake Rice Krispie tree. That's pretty cool.
That is cool.
Yeah, this is neat. That's really, really neat, actually. And those are $10.99. And then here are the pass holder. I'm not the pass holder, but the 90th birthday shirts, which there's a 3XL. And there's not many of these left.
Sorry, I'm trying to turn it just to find the price on that for y'all.
There it is, $39.99. And there it is. That's a pretty cool shirt. And that's the date today, guys, November 18th. Happy birthday, Mickey. And I like how they've stacked the dates, the years, and they've got the 90 that lines up.
That's actually brilliant.
It's really cool.
Hey, cool Disney design. Dan, how you doing?
Disney Dan, welcome to the stream, buddy. And here, what is this shirt? It's like a a little hooded long sleeve shirt.
I love Chip and Dale on everything. It's really nice.
Yeah. I like the ornaments down the arm.
Finally found the price. It's $36.99 for this one.
Yeah, I'll get the information, GB, on the cookie stroll stuff because I heard about that, and I don't really know the details right now, so I definitely want to find out. So we will find out.
I want to check out these ornaments.
Well, here's the plushes that they have.
Oh, yeah.
So here's the two set of plushes, like, with Mickey and Minnie. Yeah, the throwback Mickey and Minnie. Check those out. Yeah, Sean, Negrolando, yeah, Chippendale. So Chippendale are on everything.
Guess how much for the 90th birthday plush Mickeys and Minnie?
They're really cool.
They played a funny on this one. It's $90, $90 for
$90 even to get the 90th anniversary, 90th birthday plushes.
Yeah.
That's funny.
With each birthday, he gets more expensive.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a cute little boo.
Oh, it's the button. There we go. Oh, it's not going to go.
Not on. You grabbed the dud.
Oh, no. They probably don't spin without... they light up. You can't really see in here. There you go, guys.
Check out these ornaments. They're actually specific for the World Showcase. So they have some from China, Morocco, France.
These are really cool. They have different ones for each country.
Oh, $19.99 a piece. What's this one down here? Germany. He's cute.
Those are neat.
Good idea.
How much are these?
$19.99.
$20 a piece.
Yeah. Can't decorate the whole tree with that one.
I mean, these are neat mugs. Yeah, I haven't seen these yet. I like the color of it. How much is this?
I don't know if that celebrates anything. $19.99.
No, it's just an Epcot mug that I haven't seen before. Check out this mug, guys. I really like the design of it. I love having the spaceship Earth kind of pieces of it there on the right. And then I like the color of the mug. I like the color of the inside. And here's the other side. This is probably one of my favorite Epcot mugs that I've seen in a while. I really, really like it. And it's a nice big mug, which you've heard me complain about it before, guys. If I'm going to buy a mug, I want something that's decent size. And this is pretty cool. I like this mug a lot.
Yeah.
Maybe coming back and picking this one up.
Yeah, the shirts cool. Match the theme.
Yeah, this whole... So there's the back of the shirt, guys. And then there's the front of it. Pretty cool. Alright, let's keep moving around and go find more of the festival merchandise. Because there's not a lot here in Mouse Gear, so we're going to make our way back out towards the World Showcase. This is all Christmas, though. It's not. These aren't the festival merchandise, I don't think. Oh, there's the pass holder over there. Check that out, over there. All right, I'm going to squeeze right through here. All right, guys, I know we can get some lag in here. So if we get lag, let me know, and we'll go out. Because they have this merchandise in other places around the park. So if we get some lag, let me know. But we'll come over here and check out what they've got. Like these ornaments, which I really like. Are these metal or ceramic?
Ceramic.
And so this is all pass holder merchandise, guys. So here is all the pass holder stuff, and these are pass holder ornaments.
What's the cost on that?
These are $14.99 with Chip and Dale. These, I actually really like these pass holder magnet, or I keep calling magnets, the pass holder ornaments. Very cool.
So just like those other ornaments, they actually have a pass holder one.
That one's cool too.
Yeah, I really like that one. Also $19.99.
Yeah, I really like this. And so here is the pass holder shirt. This is the long sleeve pass holder shirt. Craig, is this the one of the shirts that you were talking about, I think, Craig?
It doesn't look like it's completely long sleeve. It's like one of those three-quarter sleeves.
Yeah, not really... like full long sleeves, but the design is pretty cool. Chip and Dale carrying the pass holder ornament. And those are $34.99. All right, let's see. There's also, what is this? Okay. Let me squeeze over here, honey. So there's also a hoodie here. Oh, this is food and wine.
Yeah, that's...
This is a food and wine festival hoodie. Trying to dump those off on us. Yeah, Craig, this is a very, very soft shirt.
Definitely super soft.
Yeah, this is a really soft shirt. And so they still have some food and wine stuff. And then there's this. 12 days of socks. I want to check this out. So here is the 12 days of socks. Check it out. This is cool. So, you get all of these different styles of socks. Isn't that pretty cool? That's neat. So it's, I don't know if they're all the same design, you know, about, but then just different sizes or different like shapes and styles of socks. But that's kind of a cool thing. 12 days of socks for $29.99. That's just kind of interesting. That's cool. Yeah, it's like 12 different styles.
Yeah.
Isn't that cool?
That is kind of cool.
Something different.
I wish they had these in kid sizes. We'll have to look around because I know our kids would think that was really, really cool to count it
Dan,
down.
When Food and Wine finishes, any food left over can be donated to the Disney Dan Donation Fund. Feet in the socks. Nope. I could try on all the socks and be like, hey, can I try on all of these socks? You gonna get one of those? Yeah. Alright, cool. Alright, Stephanie's gonna pick something up, guys, and we're gonna keep looking around. Let me know if we get any lag. Like I said, I know that we can get lag in the store, so if we do, just let me know.
That's really nice.
Yeah, check that out.
I really like that. What is it? It's free. Oh, there
all
it goes.
Rob, food. Food in the socks.
So basically the totes, if you spend $40, then you can get the tote for $24.99. And it doesn't have a price listed. I don't guess you could just buy it outright.
Yeah, I bet you can. Or maybe not. Oh, maybe not. Maybe you have to buy the $40 worth of merchandise so then you can get the $20 tote. All right. Actually, it's $24.99 with any purchase of $40 or more. That's pretty cool. All right, what else do we got in here? Steph left me.
Holiday shirts over here.
Over here on this side?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we're coming over to this side, guys. Again, keep me updated on the quality of the stream. If we have any issues, we will duck out. Where did you see those, Steph?
Right over there on that wall, there's the holiday shirt. I don't know if it's for the festival.
Plates you cannot put food on. That's true. That's going to be my favorite thing. Oh, yeah, there's a lot of people over here, too, honey. So I'm not going to go over there. We'll check out these that merchandise out here.
I'm going to hop in. I'll catch right up with you.
Okay, I'll be right out here, okay? So here's some of the graphic tees. The $20 each when you buy two. And I've bought some of these shirts. Oh, I really like this one. I bought some of these shirts before because they did the attraction shirts, where they had pirates, they had Tiki Room and Space Mountain, and they were all the graphic tees that were $20 when you buy two, $20 each. And this one I really like. Here, I'll show you. Just laying it out because it was folded up. But right here, it's the Walt Disney Productions Mickey Mouse Sound Cartoons. I think this is a cool shirt, and I like the color of it too. You just smelled Disney store, Rob, that clean plasticky smell. Yep, you got it. So yeah, these are $24.99, but $20 when you buy two of them. And this is actually a pretty cool one. Oh, we got a little bit of lag. All right, we will move over here. Yeah, they did have a cutting board that you can cut food on, because we had the cutting board. Now, we haven't cut food on it, but there was no warning sticker on it saying that you're gonna, you know, die if you cut food on it. So that's kind of interesting, guys. Yeah, I love that shirt too, Rob. I think I'm gonna have to pick one of those up. But check these out. So again, this is some of the merchandise you can get outside of Epcot. That's not for the festival, but just Christmas merchandise in general. And they've got the throwback Minnie and Mickey Nutcrackers. And then a little castle. And this one has an LED light in it that lights up. It's pretty cool. All right. We're going to step out here, guys. We're going to continue to look at merchandise, but we're going to actually get outside of Mouse Gear and go over towards the World Showcase and start looking at merchandise around there. I'm just waiting on Steph real quick to make a purchase and then come on back out here, and we will be ready to go. But while we're waiting, I will welcome all of you. We've got 115 people watching. Thank you all so much for joining us early this morning here from Epcot. I know it's an early morning stream, but it's kind of fun to come out here at a different time, especially with the time changing now. The evening streams that I do in the middle of the week, it's dark by time the stream starts, and it's a different kind of stream. So coming out here early in the morning, checking out opening day of the Festival of the Holidays, which is one of my favorite festivals, and we'll talk about that here in a little bit too. But you know, one of my favorite festivals here, and also celebrating Mickey Mouse's 90th birthday. And we have a fast pass, guys, to go meet up with Mickey Mouse here in just a little while. So we're gonna do that, and we'll go tell Mickey Mouse happy birthday, and you guys can come along with us. But if you are here for the first time, make sure to hit that subscribe button, and you'll be notified next time we go live, whenever we put up vlogs. And also, if you are enjoying this morning, make sure to hit that thumbs up. I really, really would appreciate you to hit that like button. And we'll get moving here in just a moment. Yeah, perfect time for you, Dan. What time is it right now over there in the UK where you're located? Those late night streams get a little bit hard on you, I know. Yeah, it is a beautiful day out here today, Jennifer. Look at that sky. Matthew, welcome to the stream. Yeah, no problem at all, Matthew. Completely understand. Thank you for stopping in. I really appreciate it. And look at the Christmas tree over there, guys, in the distance. We'll definitely be going to check out Epcot's Christmas tree here in a bit, too. All right, let's continue moving, and we will go over. It's 2:48 in the afternoon. That is perfect, Dan. So you've already had lunch and everything. Oh, we just got a super chat from Douglas Travel for £1.99. He says, early morning streams are better for us here in the United Kingdom. Yeah, I completely understand, Douglas. Thank you so much for that super chat. And I'm so happy you were able to come out today and do this early morning stream for you guys. And I'm so happy you could join us. So thank you so much for that super chat. I really appreciate it. Everyone, thank Douglas. Oh, Tina, closing date for the festival. That is such a great question. I believe it is, I just saw it this morning. We'll grab a book over here and we'll see it. But I'm pretty sure that it is, I'm pretty sure it's just after January. It's the first or second week of January, I believe. So we'll take a look and see when we grab one of the little food books. I'm Mickey Mouse. Oh boy, thank you for coming to my birthday stream. Oh boy! That's awesome. Here comes a monorail, guys. Check out this shot. Joshua, super chat. Down in the chat, there's a little icon over on the left-hand side of the where you type in your chat, and it's I think it's a little dollar symbol. And if you click on that, that's how you do it. And then if you want to donate, you can donate anytime as well from my PayPal link down in the description of the video. But thank you very much. I appreciate that. Monorail shot. Stephanie, polo! Polo! I shouldn't be that hard to find since I literally have a video tracker. Oh, let's go check this out. So joyful, a celebration of the seasons. So I can admit, guys, that I'm not nearly as prepared as I usually am for the start of new festivals. Usually I have a little bit more details about everything that's going on, but I've been very busy lately and did not get a chance to get as completely up to speed. But you can see here, we'll have the live performances. I know, I just don't know exactly what all the live performances are here, and we may find out here in just a moment. But happening every day, all of these times, so every hour from 125 to 425, and there you go, guys. They're appearing through December 30th, so I'm just gonna assume that the festival ends on December 30th as well. So those of you who are asking, or at least all the performances here end on December 30th. Oh, we got a super chat from Samantha Lowe for $9.99. My mom misses you guys. We're watching from the road. Thank you so much, Samantha. Really, really appreciate that. That's so awesome. And it was so amazing hanging out with you guys. And those of you who don't know, Samantha is Donna's daughter. And we had so much fun with Donna and Samantha here on their trip. We got to hang out multiple times. And if you guys were around with us on Thursday night, Donna and Samantha took us up to the Top of the World Lounge to watch Holiday Wishes fireworks. And it was amazing. We just had a great time. Thank you so much, Samantha, you and your mom, for both of your support of our channel and of so many of us here in Walt Disney World. We really, really appreciate it. Everyone, put hearts in the stream for Samantha and Donna. Thank you very much. I wanted to come over and check this out. Oh, it talks about the show. So performed in styles of gospel, rhythm and blues, and jazz. This is right up my alley, guys. I think this would be a great show to catch. Unfortunately, we will not be streaming at 125 today, but I definitely will be back for more afternoon streams as well during this festival, so we'll check it out then. But this looks like it would be a very cool show. Oh, the 11-layer cake, yes, and fireworks. That was amazing. Steph's back!
I found y'all.
I'm glad you were able to find us.
Well, it streams just a few seconds behind, so I'm where you
you're
once
always,
were.
You're always chasing me down?
Yes.
I gotta wait in one spot for a few minutes.
Oh, it feels so good out here.
It does feel, it feels amazing. Where did Marshmallow Man go?
He's looking for marshmallows. He was looking at different snack options. I'm pretty sure I was just in a family's photo. I feel a little sad about that.
I'm not sad about it. I've been in so many photos because I just like, I'm always walking behind someone as they're taking their photo. You have a great day too, Matthew. Thank you so much for stopping in. I really appreciate it. Yeah, Marshmallow Man's out looking for Coco. But that can be dangerous for Marshmallow Man, Craig. Coco's like kryptonite to Marshmallow Man. You could just see like a little cartoon of a marshmallow like standing on the edge of a like a coffee cup with boiling hot chocolate, like looking down, you know, sweating. Check out Goofy. I love these topiaries.
It's almost like the Christmas Carol. See how he has the nightcap on?
Yeah.
I love it.
Donald.
Scrooge.
Skate rentals and skating rink.
He has the skate around him. You see it?
Paige Miss Tomorrow. Marshmallow Man is actually my brother. That's what he goes by in the stream is Marshmallow Man. And he's here oftentimes on my live streams and kind of hangs behind the scenes. Not really on camera as much, but that is his screen name, is Marshmallow Man. And welcome to the stream, Paige Miss Tomorrow. If I didn't see you when you came in, welcome Nate or Veronica, or both, whichever. But thank you for coming into the stream. I really, really appreciate that. Everyone, check out Paige Miss Tomorrow. I know, Veronica, if that's you, I know that you guys work oftentimes on the weekends, so just curious if you're going to make it out today or not to the festival, because we'll be here for quite a while. Check out the snowman. I love this snowman. And none of these are open yet. So, what time is it?
It is going on 10 o'clock now. 9:57.
Oh, just Veronica. Not just Veronica, but only Veronica. Won't be going anywhere today. We're working. Oh, that stinks. We'll definitely catch up with you guys soon. According to Mission Control, Marshmallow Man is a man made out of marshmallows. Well, that's awesome. Thanks, Veronica. Thanks for joining in. Ooh, missing the monorail shot.
Snuck up on us.
It did.
Look how clear the skies are today. Going around the World Showcase later, trying out all the different festival foods is going to be amazing.
It is going to be amazing. And you can see, guys, when you look across the water here, this festival is much smaller than the Food and Wine Festival. So if you look across at all that scrim over where all the booths were on this side that kind of extended outside of the World Showcase, and none of that is here for for this festival, for the Festival of the Holidays. So... There's two that I have bought. And I can hear the Christmas music playing here in the World Showcase. And the food booths, they do not open until 11 a.m. But we can come back here and hopefully maybe check out some of the menus.
It's currently 10 o'clock. We have a fast pass between 9:30 and 10:30 for Living with the Land. Mickey's not until 10:30.
Okay. So maybe we go over there just before 10:30. Look how beautiful that tree is.
Look at the size of that ornament, the bottom one.
I know.
Oh, can you focus in on the globe up there? I'm not sure if it'll pick it up. I think it's...
Yeah.
It looks like it's shadowed, but it's like the world.
Right there. Yeah, it's a, that's a really cool ornament.
That's awesome.
Isn't that a cool ornament? Oh, JB just realized you'll be at Epcot 10 days from today. That's amazing. Well, I hope you enjoy your trip. Where can you get a Mickey's birthday pin? Well, they're giving away buttons here this morning, but I know that they did have some pins, and I'm not sure if you can get them on Shop Disney or not. But how cool is that? That's so beautiful. I do think it's cool how everything is at a, on these trees are at a larger size. If you guys were with me on my stream from the resorts the other night, then you saw those gigantic ornaments that are on the big Christmas tree outside of the Contemporary, because you can get right up against those. And they were really, really cool.
To the future
now. Just coming around this side where we got a better view with the sun, because the sun's shining on this side. So you can see all of the different countries represented. The United States is right up there. I can see the American flag. But then, yeah, like Stephanie pointed out, those globe ornaments are really cool.
And it's hard to capture this on camera, but this tree is massive.
Yeah, this tree is massive. I don't even know how to guess how tall it actually really is.
I'm going
to
walk around and see if there's something posted on the size of it, or maybe some info on it. I'll be back.
Are we playing live stream Dare today? Veronica, that could be trouble. The live stream dares only happen on evening streams. It's a little too early for that, don't you think? Any rides today or just shopping? So we have a fast pass for Living with the Land, guys. Thought that might be a nice relaxing ride to go on. And it's over on that side of Future World where we're going to be going to meet Mickey Mouse for his birthday, because we have a fast pass to meet Mickey too. So as soon as we're done over here, I think we'll run over there and maybe do a quick ride on Living with the Land and then go meet Mickey Mouse and tell him happy birthday. All right, let's walk this direction. I don't think the merchandise shops here are open yet. Veronica. See, we need to go do a vlog together, Veronica, where we just do that. We do like a dare vlog where we go out and we dare each other to do things like that. That way we have someone to film it. That would be so much fun.
I think I'll sit that one out.
Steph will sit it out, but I know that you and Nate would be, and I'm up for it. I'll do anything as far as going into groups like that, especially really really just awkward encounters like that.
I accidentally just photobombed somebody's photo, so I'll probably be on somebody's Christmas card this year.
So check this out, guys.
That.
So Peppermint Sundae. Steph already saw this and really wanted it.
I really want it.
It's chocolate ice cream with whipped cream and peppermint candy.
That's perfect.
So this is at the Holiday Sweets and Treats. And then they also have this, the Holiday Tree Sugar Cookie.
I'd like to see how they have that one, like, frosted. I bet it'll be nice. Eggnog.
Veronica says, you have no idea how hilarious that would be. Stephanie, you have to come. Yeah, we'll do it. We're going to plan it, Veronica, for sure. Let's get together and plan that, because how great would that be?
I'll basically just be blushing in the background somewhere.
Because we have...
Veronica says your hat, they're lucky because you're in their Christmas card stuff.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, Jennifer, that's so awesome. I'm glad that the colors and everything looks good. Early morning and evening streams, you know, when the sun's low, the colors do come pretty nicely. So yeah, I know Veronica's fearless. There's no way I'm winning the challenge, but it'll be fun just to be a part of it. And TG Lee eggnog is just kind of funny, guys. Like, hey, we've got TG Lee eggnog for $3.50 for a tiny glass when you can, you know, just buy up probably a half gallon or a whole gallon for $3.50. It's like, did they really have to put that it's TG Lee eggnog just to let you know that they're just getting it, you know, from TG Lee?
Yep, straight from Publix.
Yeah, straight from Publix. But then check it out, guys. For those of you who are drinkers, they got the Fire Nog, TG Lee eggnog with Fireball Cinnamon Whiskey for $9.50. Well, like I said, none of these are open until 11. So we'll be coming around and trying out some of these menu items in the vlog. But for right now, we're just going to go around and check out the different menus. Damn, my man. If you want to go to the UK Pavilion, we will go to the UK Pavilion just for you, Dan. Let's head that direction right now. Yeah, Tyler, that's a good one too. Or stand in front of Cinderella's castle and just say, you know, I don't know, where's the castle? Like, have your back to it. Just, like, really obvious things like that. Milky alcohol sounds horrid, Veronica says. I love eggnog, JB. I agree. Eggnog is something I really look forward to around this time of the year. I mean, you can get it any time of the year. But, guys, have you ever made homemade eggnog before? I did that once. And the process of it, when you make it, it looks absolutely disgusting because it's got all those egg yolks in it. And Steph wouldn't drink it because you've got to get the eggs up to a certain temperature without cooking them. And Steph was just not, she didn't believe that I actually got it up to the right temperature. So she thought she was just going to drink raw eggs. So I had to drink all the eggnog myself.
It was a little shady, y'all. I didn't want to risk it.
So here is the Yukon Holiday Kitchen. Oh, look, they actually open at 12. That's
wow.
Interesting, because I thought it said open at 11 a.m., but 12.
We're ready to eat.
I'm starving. So check it out, the seared salmon.
Look at the maple.
This looks really good.
Y'all are going to have to forgive us in this vlog, because a lot of the items here this year have some fancy names, and we ain't quite that fancy, but it looks so good. Check out that one.
Yeah, this one looks really, really good. It's like a log. We're going to call it a maple Noel log.
We'll cheat our way through this one.
Yeah, this is going to be a fun vlog to film later when we're like, yeah, we're here trying the... I'm going to say it's maple bûcher de Noel.
I think you got the de Noel right, but the bûcher?
I think it's bûcher. Maple bûcher.
It's like Bobby Boucher from The Water Boy.
Bobby Boucher.
I told you I wasn't too fancy.
The maple bûcher de Noel. And the frozen coffee looks good, too.
That actually looks delicious.
Looks like it's got like a toasted marshmallow or something on top.
Marshmallow.
But yeah, there's the maple bûcher de Noel. Maple mousse rolled in gingerbread...
Chiffon
cake.
I got that
with
one.
With cranberry sauce and pecan crumble for $4.50. Guys, so, you know,
said,
we were...
My mama said that was good.
you know, we were talking about, does everyone know what eggnog is? Yeah, guys, do you know what eggnog is? It's basically, you know, heavy cream, milk, eggs, and then a bunch of seasonings that taste delicious. Like, there's fresh cloves in eggnog, cinnamon... Dan, have you never had eggnog? Oh, there's the cookie trail stuff Steph found. I wanted to find out about the cookie trail, and you guys were asking about it. So let's go check out the details of the holiday cookie stroll. So here it is. Here's all the details.
I know. I was just talking to somebody who showed me the... beautiful pictures.
Okay, so how does this work? Make this holiday season sweeter than usual and indulge in this year's holiday cookie stroll. So look, if you purchase any 5 cookies from the holiday cookie stroll locations on the following page, make sure to collect the matching stamp for each cookie you purchase, then bring it back to the passport to the holiday sweet and treats, and you get your
complimentary.
The completer cookie and an icy cold glass of milk. So how cool is that?
So basically, you eat 5 cookies, they'll give you another cookie and some milk.
Yeah. Yeah, so if you eat all the cookies, so let's check out these cookies, guys, because they're quite impressive. So the red and green chocolate chip cookie, and that's at the Feast of the Three Kings. The peppermint sugar cookie looks delicious. And as we go down, the green and white sugar cookie, that's at the American Pavilion. Look, the black and white cookie. I love black and white cookies.
Cory's more of the black and white cookie type. I seen that peppermint sugar cookie, and that's got my name on
it
all day.
The black and white. I love black and white cookies so much, guys. When we were in New York, we were down at Greenwich Village, this little bakery. I brought home a bunch of black and white cookies on the plane because they were so good, and they're huge in New York. I mean, these are probably smaller versions, but those of you who are up in New York, I know you know the black and white cookies. Gold chocolate chip cookie. That one looks good too. And then there's your completer cookie.
Oh.
So it's a Mickey cookie.
But it's just a sugar cookie with fancy on top.
Yeah, but you can only get it if you get the other 5. And then you get the completer cookie.
You also might get diabetes.
And a glass of milk. Oh, you might get diabetes too. That's true. Joshua says, guess what, Stephanie? I moved to America.
That is awesome. Welcome to the States.
Welcome. How much are each cookie? I don't know because the prices aren't back there on those cookies, so I'm not sure how much they actually cost. If I see in one of the on one of the menus, I'll let you guys know. A gold cookie.
I'm pretty sure I saw it on one of them, and they were in the $3 range, the $3 to $4 range.
Okay, that sounds about right. I would just do the cookie stroll over and over, DPC Dad says. Yeah, paging Miss Tomorrow. You get the gonna get the diabetes.
So you might cookies, you might eat a lot of those.
That's true.
Sure.
So one thing you might notice this morning, guys, is some people dressed really nice. That's because Dapper Day is still going on here at Disney World. I believe yesterday they started over at Animal Kingdom, went to Magic Kingdom, and today Dapper Day continues here at Epcot. So if you see people walking by that looked way overdressed for the day here in Epcot, that's the reason why. Hello, my name is Wilson, and I want to talk about my diabetes. Don't eat them, just collect them if you can. Dale, that would be cool, except for I would be so tempted to eat them all. Hey, Dan, welcome home, buddy. I'm looking for Dan here because he's got to be somewhere around, right? Do they have like a picture of you, Dan, hanging up inside of one of these buildings, like a poster? I did see Rachel's Dapper Day pic. It was very cool. Actually, I saw the one with just her, so I never saw one with Peter in it. So I know Peter dressed up too, right? Or didn't
Peter
he?
Peter had to take the photo.
Yeah, someone had to take the picture. Dan, I'm looking for your booth. Do they even have a booth for this festival here? Maybe not. Do you not have a Christmas booth, Dan? That's kind of depressing. I do. It's very kind. I'm like not talking because we're just like strolling through here and it looks so amazing. Dan says, that's my house. I love the Christmas music as we're going back through here. Yeah. Good day from Australia. Visiting next May. Carrie, that's awesome.
May's usually a real nice time to visit weather.
May is nice.
Nice.
Oh, is Veronica heading out? Veronica, thank you very much for stopping in. And we will definitely very soon do that awesome vlog where we do a dare vlog. That would be so much fun. Have a good day at work, Veronica. It's pretty back here.
Very pretty.
Look at this, guys. Very relaxing.
I know. We're almost alone with 144.
Yeah, everyone say bye to Paging Mr. Morrow. Have a good day at work, Veronica. Everyone, if you have not checked out Paging Mr. Morrow, make sure to go over and subscribe to Paging Mr. Morrow. They do a great job with their vlogs multiple times a week. I don't know if they do every day or not. I don't remember. Close to it. So they put out a lot of content, and her and Nate are so much fun. So definitely go check out Paging Mr. Morrow. Veronica, I know how old I am. Yeah, Veronica messaged me out of nowhere recently, guys, and was like, do you realize how old you are? Or I never realized how old you are. She thought that just from seeing us, which many people do, that we were like really young, like in our 20s.
I try to remind them all the time, Veronica.
But guys, I am actually 32 years old. I don't mind saying it. And everyone thinks that that's crazy, including Veronica, thought that it was totally a big surprise that I was as old as I am. I don't think that's that old, but
it's pretty old.
Do the maze. All right, Dan, we'll go over to the maze. Someone said don't forget your fast passes. That's right. We've got what? 14 minutes if we want to go do the Living with the Land before going to meet Mickey.
We're gonna have to high knees that walk then. I actually never knew this maze was here. I mean, it's not very complicated because you can kind of see over it, but
it's fun though.
It's pretty back here.
Yeah, it is. I'd like to have one of these in our backyard. Who's gonna trim all the bushes though?
Not you.
Alyssa and Neil, thank you very much.
I'm gonna stop following Cory. He literally.
We're going in circles. Yes, Dennis, we're doing Thanksgiving. We actually do like a double Thanksgiving because Stephanie's grandmother cooks, and then we do something with my parents. So it's like we do a lunch meal and then a dinner meal. It's a whole day of eating.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Don't get lost, Dan. Yeah, I'm trying not to. Oh, we can't go that way. Alyssa, have a good one. Thanks for coming in. I think there's multiple ways out. Deep fried turkey, Tyler. You know what my favorite is, guys? Oh, yeah, I went the wrong way. Look at Steph. Steph is lost in the maze. Where are you going? That's not the right way.
You're in the way.
Yeah, but this is the true exit. See, this is the finish line.
Well, watch this.
Look, you're over there.
Magic.
You're over there.
And now I'm over here.
What? It's a small maze, but it's a lot of fun. Thanks, Dan. All right, guys, we got 150 people watching. Thank you all.
154, that's amazing.
Thank you all so much for joining the stream. If it's your first time here, make sure to hit that subscribe button. We're having a lot of fun checking out opening morning here of the Festival of the Holidays in Epcot. And it's also Mickey's 90th birthday. So make sure to hit that subscribe button. It's your first time. You'll get notified next time we go live and upload vlogs. And if you're enjoying the day so far, please hit that thumbs up. We're at 153, and we should be up to 100 likes by now. So hit that thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it, guys. All right, so festival, it's gonna be here. It's going on. There's all kinds of stuff to check out. Now, I know that they'll stop us over here on the other side of the bridge and won't let us go since the World Showcase is not officially open yet. So because of that, we'll head back this way and maybe go catch our Fast Pass.
For Living with the Land?
Yeah.
That's one of my favorites.
So if we can get there in time, if not, I'm sure the wait isn't that long yet. We'll go ride Living with the Land, guys. You want to go relax on a nice little boat ride on Living with the Land, then we will go meet Mickey Mouse, and then we'll come back over here and check out some more of these menus. But how does that sound, guys? Like a plan? Look how beautiful it is.
Disney dance, as we have a British people, they have a fascination with hedge mazes.
Wait.
What?
Casey said, just passed y'all. Have a fantastic day.
Oh.
Casey, say hi. Don't ever feel like you are interrupting us. Definitely say hi. We really appreciate seeing everyone, and it's a lot of fun. So what did Dan say? I missed it.
Oh, Dan says that as British people, they have a fascination with the hedge mazes.
Oh, Humphrey watching from Alberta, Canada, first time watching. Thank you so much for joining. I really appreciate it. Make sure you're subscribed so you're notified next time we go live. And guys, copyright claim all day long. So we're just going to keep talking over this. Not that we haven't reached any other copyright claims with the other music that's been going on, but this one very... particularly has a very distinct melody that I know could easily... Yeah, it's getting louder and louder. It's like, gonna copyright claim on you. What's our favorite ride at Epcot? So guys, my favorite ride at Epcot is Spaceship Earth. It's a classic. I really enjoy it. Steph?
Well, I kind of have two. I love Soarin' just because of the smells, the way it feels when you're riding it, but there's something extremely relaxing to me about living with the land. I actually remember that when I came here, I think it was like in third grade for a field trip for school. Yeah. I remember riding it back then, and I don't know, it's just very nice to me still.
Yeah, I agree. Living with the land's awesome, guys. And we did a stream back during the VI pass holder event that they had here at night, where we rode Living with the Land for the first time when it was dark, and going to the greenhouse at night was so cool.
Yeah, that was pretty awesome. I watched that one from home, actually, and I was really jealous because I've never done that one at night. Oh, yes, I did. I was here for that one.
You were here for that event.
You know, that was pretty late, and it was getting past my bedtime.
It was cool.
I shut down after 10. Sorry.
WW Bound, good morning. Welcome to the stream. I have heard that they're going to be doing some stuff with Spaceship Earth, but I haven't heard the details. Guys, so much news came out yesterday and even more coming out today. And I'm not even up to speed on everything, but I know that some more details came out about the new nighttime show that's going to be replacing Illuminations. And again, I'm not completely up to date on all the details, but I do know that from what I've seen, this show, the new nighttime show that ultimately is going to take over in about a year after the show closes, is going to be eerily similar to Happily Ever After. Heard a clip of the soundtrack, saw some of the video footage of the projections, and it is going to be very, very similar to... Happily Ever After, meaning that it is just full of Disney music, and this is all music related to Disney films. It's all intellectual property stuff, so it's, I think some people are gonna love it, some people are gonna absolutely hate it, but it's gonna be similar, almost too similar from what I saw to Happily Ever After, so we'll see what ends up happening. But then there's gonna be the show that's in between, so for a year, When Illuminations closes for a year while they're transitioning to get ready for that show, there will be a in-between show that happens, which I do not know the details for yet. But all we saw yesterday was kind of what's coming. So this is all news that is coming out of the Destination D event that's happening here in Orlando. And also, they announced that that Mickey's Runaway Railway will open in fall of 2019. And they also announced that the Skyway will open, or the Skyliner, the new gondola system, will open in fall of 2019 as well. So guys, fall of 2019, it's going to be insane. We're going to have Runaway Railway, we're going to have the Skyliner, we're going to have Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. So much going on next year, towards the end of the year. It's going to be pretty crazy.
I have a small little problem.
What's that?
I'm starting to sweat in winter.
Yeah. So it was cool this morning, guy. Like almost cool enough to where you need pants. we're wearing pants. I know we got people watching from all different countries, and you say
we
pants.
Call them shorts.
We're wearing shorts. We're not wearing long pants. But you almost needed that this morning when we left the house, but it's already warmed up quite a bit. Yeah, Ashley, I don't know the details about that show, but I do know that it is going to be more along the lines of classic Epcot, that in-between show. So if they do that show really well, I could see people getting quite upset when that one ends and then the next one starts. So we'll see what ends up happening. But I know that I haven't seen really many details about it yet. And it may have came out yesterday, and because I'm not up to speed, I don't know yet. Josh, welcome to the stream, Resort TV One. Everyone say hi to Resort TV One. Thanks for coming in. Josh and Jenna did such an amazing job on Friday night with their stream of the Christmas party at Magic Kingdom. It was so much fun. a lot of fun times to be had in that stream. Guys, if you're not following Resort TV One, make sure to click over there and subscribe. They do an amazing job, and Josh is so supportive of us and the whole community. So go over there and subscribe.
Seems like whenever Josh comes in, we start heading to Living with the Land.
Yeah, Josh, last time we were at Epcot and you jumped in, we were going to Living with the Land. We are on our way there right now. Oh, did Josh hit 38,000 subscribers? Congratulations, Josh and Jenna, Resort TV One, for 30,000 subscribers. That's amazing. Such a big accomplishment. Congratulations.
Yeah, awesome job, you guys. You definitely deserve it.
Yeah, 155 watching. Thanks, guys. Thank you for joining us. So we're going to go ride Living with the Land. I know that on the ride, we'll have just a little bit of a lag right at the beginning of the ride. But other than that, everything streams beautifully. So enjoy. And then, yeah, 40,000 coming before the end of the year. Josh, you're on track to hit that. That's amazing. What a big accomplishment. I'll tell you what, we're going to have to like plan just like a big celebration for 50,000. So we'll just plan to have like a get together. You gotta have a cake, right? It's like there's a cake for Mickey's 90th birthday. There needs to be a cake for Resort TV One getting to 50,000 subscribers. But yeah, 40,000 right around the corner. That's amazing. It's a little bit busy in here this morning, that's for sure.
Living with the Land, I can see downstairs, already has a pretty big standby line. I wonder if they have any of the Mickey birthday celebration like cupcakes or cookies in here.
I'm sure they have something down there. We'll check it out when we get off. So guys, if you're just joining us, you weren't here when I was talking about it before, we're going to ride Living with the Land. As soon as we're done with Living with the Land, we have a fast pass to go tell the boss himself, Mr. Mickey Mouse, happy birthday, because today is his 90th birthday. So get ready for that. As soon as we're done, we're going to go say happy birthday. We'll also check out to see if there's any specialty cupcakes here inside of Sunshine Seasons.
We have 2 minutes to get to our fast pass. We can do it.
We can do it. 2 minutes. Yeah, look at the line, guys. Already pretty busy over here for Living with the Land. 30-minute wait currently for standby.
Okay, 1 minute to our fast pass time. Maybe not.
We got it. So we'll also be checking out more merchandise, guys. I know we did some early shopping this morning already, checking out not only Festival of the Holidays merchandise, but also some 90th Happy Birthday Mickey merchandise. And we'll check out more of that. Once the World Showcase opens up, there'll be a lot more to see. And we'll head over there and check that out as well. Yeah, even the Fast Pass line is a little bit crazy. We're in. Oh, Dale, if we walk around the lands for each cookie, that should burn off the calories. That's true. Burn off the calories that we add by eating all the cookies, probably. That's true, Dan. Too much time drinking up the Beverly to ride Living with the Land. We had a super chat from Donna for $9.99. Hi, Cory, Stephanie, and Marshmallow Man. Just stopped for gas on our way home and had to jump on and say hi to everyone. Don't forget to smash that like button and ring the bell. Thanks, everyone. Donna, thank you so much for that super chat. We really, really appreciate it. And guys, we had such a great time with Donna over the last week, 2 weeks actually, that she was here in town. And she's driving home today, driving from Orlando to Oklahoma. So safe travels, Donna. Thank you so much for being in. Awesome. Good morning, Red. Welcome to the stream. We love you too, Donna. Thank you so much. And the wait, guys, the fast pass wait right now for Living with the Land is kind of insane. We haven't moved. We got in here and we literally have not moved. You can see it's backed up all the way around here. All right, thanks, Josh. Thank you so much for stopping in. Everyone say bye to Josh and Resort TV One. Go check them out if you haven't. I know many of you are already subscribed, but if you're not, you need to be, so make sure you get over there and subscribe. And Josh, have a great day. Thanks for stopping in. I appreciate it. When we're usually moving our way through, and the ride itself streams really well, we only have a little bit of. So I think we should be back. I'm showing that we're at a full connection now. So if it still looks a little bit laggy or appears to have an issue, just make sure to hit that refresh button. Also, make sure you're set to 720p because we are streaming in 720p. So hit that little gear or the three little dots and switch your signal over to the 720p quality, and we should be good. Yeah, so I was waiting for our lag to go away to mention the super chat. Guys, we got a super chat from Johnny Boy for $5 that says, love your channel. My four kids, wife, and I look forward to all your videos. 70 days till our Disney adventure begins. Thank you so much, Johnny Boy, for that super chat. We really appreciate it. And I hope you have an amazing trip in 70 days. I know it gets very exciting counting down the days to your trip. I hope it's amazing. Everyone, put hearts in the stream for Johnny Boy. And thank you to you and your family to all your for all your support. I really appreciate it. All right, not too much longer, guys, and we will be on the ride here. Thank you so much, Johnny Boy. I really appreciate that. Guys, we're getting close to the ride. We're gonna ask for the front so we get the best view on the stream. And remember, we'll get a little bit of lag right at the beginning of the ride, but it's only for a second, and then it clears right up. So just hang in there with us and enjoy an awesome ride on Living with the Land. And then up next, guys, going to meet Mickey Mouse. I love this. Love this area back here. This whole building is really nice. You ready for Living with the Land? You said it's one of your favorites.
It really is. It's relaxing. It's usually not so crowded, so it's a good place to get away from the crowd. Not so much today, but it's still a very relaxing, calming ride. And you never know. They might have something for the festival in there.
You ready for some food?
I'm always ready for something.
I like it because during the Flower and Garden Festival, they have the little markers with the different vegetables and stuff that they use, and that's pretty cool to see. I don't think they do anything like that during this festival. Can we wait for one, please?
Wait for a one?
Yes, please.
Just hang on to the side.
Sure.
Come here, the next one. 2 and 3, please.
I'm ready for food too, for sure.
Don't video me, buddy. Don't video me.
You got it.
Number one for the next one.
All right.
Come in the next one. Enjoy.
Yes. 10:38 right now. Thank you very much. Yeah, our fast pass for Mickey started at 10:30, so we've got until 11:30 to use it. So we'll use it as soon as we're done in here. We're gonna go straight over there. So. We got the front row, guys. Cooking and watching you guys makes for a great morning.
Thank you, Ken.
Glad you're enjoying it. Casey just subscribed. Thank you so much, Casey. Welcome to the channel. I hope you have a great time and I hope you enjoy the content. All right, guys, front row. Like I said, we're gonna lag for just a moment when we get into this first part, but it'll stop. If you have an issue with your signal, make sure to refresh and then also set back to 720 if it does lag. I'm expecting just a little bit right through the rainforest area here for just a moment, but then everything will be perfect for the rest of the ride, so just be on the lookout for that. And enjoy the ride on Living with the Land, guys. I won't be talking, won't be answering chat, so just enjoy and have a good time.
Our
surface of the land, which trap water from the flowing mud, extracting precious nutrients and metals.
Sandman here inside of the Living with the Land greenhouse. How cool are they?
Welcome to our living laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce healthy harvests now and into the future. The tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. One day, many of these lesser-known tropical plants may be as important as the bananas growing on both sides of the boat. More than 28 million tons of bananas are eaten annually, making it the most popular fruit in the world. While there are more than 50,000 edible species,
look, guys, Mickey's got a nose and antlers. That's cool.
Is an important goal of research around the world. Like water, fertilizer, and pesticides. Another innovation at work here is supplies. We are significantly reducing our reliance on conventional pesticides, chemicals, water, and nutrients. With it, we can produce over 20. Growing these ground production, the source of fertilizer for the plants, and the plant in our lab, Epcot science, healing, and better quality. On behalf of the check out the behind-the-scenes walking tour. Please keep your hands and feet inside the boat and remain seated until the boat comes to a complete stop. These greenhouses represent just a fraction of the work being done worldwide to produce bountiful harvests for our growing population. Scientists, farmers, and even backyard gardeners are doing their part to improve the quantity and quality of foods that we all rely upon. Together, we can continue to find more ways to increase food production and protect our precious natural environment. Only then will we truly be living with the land. On behalf of Walt Disney World, we hope you've enjoyed this unique journey through our living laboratory. If you'd like a closer look, then check out the Behind the Scenes walking tour. It's a chance for the whole family to get up close and personal with the plants and growing techniques in our laboratory. Please keep your hands and feet inside the boat and remain seated until the boat comes to a complete stop.
Guys, hope you enjoyed living with the land. That was fun. And hey to Disney Princess Couture. Rachel, welcome to the stream. And we miss you too. It was great seeing you and Peter. I know you just had a quick trip here and looking forward to hanging out more on your next visit or when you permanently get here. But welcome to the stream. And guys, we are going next to meet up with Mickey Mouse. Because today is Mickey's 90th birthday, so we're gonna go meet Mickey Mouse and tell him happy birthday and do that all right here live on the stream. So now, guys, would be a perfect time to share out this stream, share it out with hashtag happy birthday Mickey or wish happy, I don't know, happy birthday Mickey or Mickey live on his birthday, something along those lines. Let's get a hashtag going, guys. Someone come up with something better than me. And let's get that out there, and let's go wish Mickey Mouse a happy birthday live, guys. Mickey's 90th. There you go, Dan. Thank you very much. Yeah, everyone share out the stream with hashtag Mickey's 90th and let's get that going and go meet Mickey Mouse. All right, get up this way. Yeah, we knew Dan would come through with the hashtag. I know, we'll go. We're gonna go around more of the World Showcase and check out more of those menus, so. Mickey Mouse, hashtag today is my 90th birthday. All of us that are hashtag food for Dan. Part of the Disney Dan Fund. The Disney Dan Food Fund.
Right here.
Elevators. JB, do they have any reference to bees in the land? You know, I don't actually remember there being any reference to bees. I know during the Flower and Garden Festival, they have a whole, like a honey-themed booth that's all kind of themed to bees and has information about bees. But nothing in Living with the Land. Yeah, Rachel says, Cory. How's it going? So I hope you had a safe trip back, and I bet you landed and it was probably snow on the ground and freezing cold, and you wish you were back in Florida. I know. It's a challenge. But you can watch on here and kind of relive the beautiful weather.
Winter in shorts.
Winter in shorts, that's right. Good morning, Justin. Welcome to the stream. All right, let's do this, guys. We're going to go meet and see if we get a special bonus, because it's not just a Mickey meet and greet. It's Mickey, and it's Goofy, and it's Minnie. So we get to say hi to everyone. And, guys, it's actually Minnie's birthday, too. She gets overshadowed, but Mickey and Minnie kind of came as a package. So... But today is officially Mickey Mouse's birthday. Dan, we wish you were here right now. We really do wish you were here right now, Dan. That would be awesome. Man, even the fast sea, everyone wants to meet Mickey. Goodness. Oh my goodness, guys. Look at this. Look at this. The standby to meet Mickey is 80 minutes. And look at the fast pass line. All right, we're gonna ask to see how long this is, because that... About how long do you think the fast pass is from here?
30 minutes?
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, sorry.
All right, good. Yeah. So right now, guys, the fast pass is gonna be about 90 minutes plus to meet Mickey Mouse. Look at that. So... If you look, it goes all the way back to there. So from the entrance all the way through. That's a long wait, guys. A long wait for sure on the stream. To be live on the stream, waiting in line. I don't know. I think we might have to come back and do it on the vlog today. Yeah. And not wait. I'm so sorry, guys. That just seems like it would be a mess. I think you guys agree that waiting in line for 30 minutes on stream is not the ideal thing. That's a long time. And I could tell you right now, 30 minutes is gonna be very, you know, that's optimistic. I think that's probably gonna be more of a 45 minute long wait for sure. Wait until he's 180. Yeah, that's a long wait, guys. On the stream, I don't want to just sit there in the line. There's more things that we could go do. Yeah, well, guys, this is a good time to talk about that, the whole fast pass thing. I mean, a lot of people sometimes get upset when the fast pass is so long, but really, there's no guarantee that it's a walk-on with a fast pass. It's just that it's going to be faster than the standby, and the standby is 80 minutes long. So, I mean, a 45-minute long wait would still be, almost half the amount of time of the standby. So let's go around and look at more of the food options, guys. I'm so sorry that we can't go meet Mickey Mouse right now, but we do have our fast pass is good until 11:30. Well, we probably won't make it back over here. So we're going to continue to go around over here and check out some food. But you know what? And since we couldn't meet Mickey today, we'll do a giveaway. And we're going to give away a couple of Happy Birthday Mickey buttons. So just because we couldn't meet him doesn't mean we can't give away a couple of buttons. So let's go find a spot where we can stop. Stephanie's going to find a trivia question, guys. And we will give away a couple of the Mickey Happy Birthday Mickey buttons that they're giving out here today for Mickey's 90th birthday. So while Steph looks for a, I think I need a frosty melon. While Steph looks for a trivia question, we're gonna go into Club Cool. understand, my man. I'm not going for Beverly. I'm going for something that I actually like. Get a little shot of the melon frosty. Man, it is busy in here today, guys. Yes, Dan. Memories on the corner of my mind. Mr. Nasty Beverly memories. Do one for you. You're gonna make me do. Gonna make me do one for you. I'll do it, Dan. What the heck? There we go. Here's a Beverly. Bing bong, drinking the Beverly. We're gonna do it, guys. Let's get over here. Get over in the corner and hide. Whoa. Running out of wire. I got you guys plugged in and I was running out of wire. There we go. I lost Steph. She's out there looking for a trivia question. All right, guys. Whoa. There we go. For Dan. This is for Disney Dan, guys. Look, and I'm unfortunate too. It filled up all the way to the top, Dan. We're going to go ahead and hit a shot of Beverly. Let's do it. Not good, Dan. Not good. That's going to stick with me for the rest of the day. All it takes is one. And Dan made me do 10 of them. Can you give me a melon frosty, please?
Okay.
Steph's going to give me a melon frosty. So she's kind of busy over there. She could trick me and put a little Beverly in the bottom of it. And that would be nasty. But she's too nice to do that.
That is really good.
Dev, Prince Charming Dev, welcome to the stream. Everyone say hi to Prince Charming Dev. I know Dev traveled back to back home to Oklahoma. So watching from Oklahoma. Everyone make sure to go check out Prince Charming Dev. Make sure you're subscribed. Dev does an awesome job with his Monday live streams and vlogs. And he's a good friend of mine and we have a great time together. So make sure to subscribe to Prince Charming Dev. Yeah, I wish you were here too, Dev. Gosh, the first day of this festival. It is so beautiful out here today. My frosty melon is delicious.
They are out of my Bebo today, and I'm pretty upset about that.
Oh, Dev just landed in Oklahoma. We'll have a great time, Dev. Enjoy the time with family. Relax. Disconnect from Orlando and Disney, and just have a great time. Yeah, I have so much fun. The lights in here. Oh, there they go. The lights just kicked off for the music. Gonna get some melon frosty. Actually, know what I'm gonna get now, guys? Just a little bit of old-fashioned pineapple Fanta. Let's do it. Ooh, goodness. Look at that. It kind of exploded.
How you doing?
Thank you very much. You too. All right, guys, a little bit crazy in here. Let's try and make it over to the exit. All right, Dan, I think I successfully washed that vile drink out of my mouth. And now we can continue.
I have a nice little trivia question.
Oh, Steph's got a trivia question. Let's get over here out of the sun. Ooh.
Is there any nice poster or anything we can look at while I read this off to them?
We can look over here at the Epcot timeline. As long as the signal holds up good in
now,
here.
Y'all let us know before I read this trivia question if y'all can hear us okay.
Yeah, hold on one moment. We'll make sure the signal's good. We'll get over here.
Careful, the answer might be on this wall.
Ooh, the answer might be on the wall. Well, we'll stick like this then just in case the answer is low. Yeah, it's dark over here. Did you see Mickey yet? Alex, unfortunately, the wait for Mickey right now is out of this world. It's 90-minute wait. We had a fast pass, but even with the fast pass, it was probably going to be about a 45-minute wait. and it just it's just not good for the stream to wait in line for 45 minutes. So unfortunately, we were unable to meet Mickey Mouse today, but instead, right now, to make up for not meeting Mickey Mouse, we're gonna do a giveaway. And we're gonna give away two of the buttons. You got two trivia questions?
No, I got one right now.
Okay, so we'll do one now, and then we'll do one when we get back into the World Showcase. But guys, this is to win one of these, the Happy Birthday 2018 Mickey buttons, and these are for his 90th birthday. They're giving these out as you walk in the park today. And so Stephanie has a trivia question. And so she's going to ask that question. The first person to get it right here in the chat is going to pick up one of these, and I'll ship it out to you. But check those buttons out. Aren't they cool? All right, Steph. So here goes Steph with the trivia question. Just want to make sure you can hear her well. I think everyone said we're all good. So go right ahead.
All right. The only thing I'm going to let y'all know is I am looking for a number. So here goes the question. Mickey Mouse became the first cartoon to receive a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. On which birthday did Mickey receive this award?
So what year, guys, did Mickey Mouse receive his star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame?
It wasn't which year, it's which birthday.
Oh, which birthday. Sorry, yes. Okay. So what birthday did Mickey get his star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame? Or a button.
JB Loves Disney in with the correct response.
Oh, there you go.
The 50th birthday. Good job.
JB got it in there quickly for the 50. I didn't even know the answer, and I was just guessing it. Or I was just guessing in my mind, and I guessed it would be 50.
Yeah, it's a good monumental birthday, but
there
I thought that was a great
go.
One.
JB, congratulations. You get a Happy Birthday Mickey button. And so we'll definitely get that button out to you. If you can send me your information on Instagram, send me a private message on Instagram or on Facebook with your address, we'll drop this in the mail and get this to you as soon as we can. And that's awesome. Congratulations, JB. Everyone congratulate JB. And we'll give another one of these away here shortly, guys, when we get back into the World Showcase, maybe right at the end of the stream. So hang on for that.
Oh, he says we were there that day.
Oh, were you there that day? That.
Well, hold on. Yeah.
No. Yeah, so...
I was like, wait a minute. That's a long time ago.
That is a long time ago.
Congrats
to JB. And guys, we got more, so we'll give out another one when we get back here in the World Showcase. So for the rest of the stream, what's the plan? We got to do a vlog today, guys. We're here to vlog all of the festivities, try out some of the food offerings here for the festival. So we're going to do that all in a vlog. So we're not going to be streaming for a lot longer, but we'll jump back into the World Showcase once again. Actually, you know what, Steph? Let's go back. I'm sorry. Let's go back through here because I want to see if these other merchandise spots are open out front here.
Oh, yeah. They usually have the artwork there.
Yeah. Yeah, but during these kind of festivals, I think it's all merch.
Yeah.
So we'll check it out. We'll go check out some more merch, some more of the menus back in the World Showcase, and then we'll give away another awesome button. And we'll probably end that stream and then start our vlog so we can get that done and out to you guys too. So let's head on over here. So we got a super chat. I missed that. Sorry about that. Let's see here. So we got a $5 super chat from Orlando Parks Rover. It says, happy Sunday, guys. Thank you so much, Orlando Parks Rover. I really appreciate that. Everyone put hearts in the stream for Orlando Parks Rover, thanking them for that amazing super chat. Thank you so much. We really appreciate all of your support. And happy Sunday to you.
Oh, I can hear the Christmas music now.
And they've got the band set up now, too. Because that starts at 1:25.
Okay. We'll still be here at that time. We might have to put it in the vlog.
Yeah, well, I definitely have a clip of this band playing in the vlog, guys. And look, it's open now. So you can check out more merchandise. Look at this line to get pictures.
Oh, they got more of the shirt.
Yeah, this looks like more of just the holiday. Christmas merchandise. Which we can go ahead and check out some of them because they are cool. These are some of just the general Christmas merchandise they have here.
This one's super cute though.
It is. That one is really cool.
I really like that though. This is a female shirt. I really like it.
That is a cool shirt. Check that one out, guys. It's a cool design. Diz Jake, it's going well. Thank you. Thanks for joining.
It looked like on the thing there was an auto switch on the battery.
Oh, here's all the socks, guys. So those of you who were here earlier when we were looking at the 12 days of Christmas socks, here they are. So look at them all. So they are all different designs. Look at Pluto.
Look at how cute these ones are. I like those.
That's cool. So they have them out so you can see them. Oh, that one's cool too. I like Donald. Look at him. Dale, thank you very much. Thanks for stopping
in. These are nice.
Yeah, it is a beautiful day out here today. Yeah, these socks are all very cool. That's a really cool set. It
that's
really is.
Really neat. How
it
much
is definitely
that?
A neat. I don't remember. I think it's $29.99. It's just a neat set, a unique gift here at Epcot. What is this? Oh, this is a pair of adult socks inside of a Mickey ornament. And that's pretty cool too. That's so cool. Those socks are $29.99, Marshmallow Man. We got a $4.99 super chat from Angie that says, loving the live feed. Thank you so much, Angie. Really appreciate that. $4.99. Everyone give a thumbs up or give a heart in the stream for Angie and thank her so much for the $4.99 super chat. Thank you so much for that support. We really appreciate it. Awesome. Here's another shirt. The holidays are pure magic. I like Mickey.
I do like that.
Mickey just looks great in that
yeah,
on that shirt.
Yeah, the colors are very vibrant.
They are. I was looking for the price. I'm sure this is $29 or $24 or something. Sometimes they make the prices hard to find.
Oh, it's on the back.
Oh, it is?
It's $24.99.
That's not bad at all.
Yeah, that's a cute one.
All right, guys. All right, let's go over to the other side of here because this side is just like Christmas merchandise. And I think when we go around to the other side of here, it will be the festival specific merchandise. And I love, love, love the snowman. So cool. And at night, he lights up really cool. All right, let's go over here. DPC Dad asked that red shirt was soft. I don't remember. I wasn't feeling
it. It was like your typical Disney shirt. It wasn't like the super soft material, but it wasn't like so scratchy. It's just the typical Disney shirt.
Craig, whenever you ask if it's soft, I don't know if you are a Seinfeld fan, but if you remember that episode of Seinfeld, every time you ask if it's soft, I think of the who goes around feeling other people's material? Check all these stockings out. These are huge.
Look at this. Now, I know there are some other folks in the stream who also appreciate Stitch. Look at this one.
That's an awesome Stitch shirt. It's a Stitch and a Tiki Room all in one. That is awesome.
That's an awesome stocking. I'm that pretty is. Sure we need to update our stockings at home.
That's really, really cool. Disney Dan, going to be heading out, Cory and Stephanie. Really awesome stream. Have a magical day, everyone. Disney Dan, thank you so much for all your help in here today in the stream. We really appreciate it. Everyone, give a big thank you to Disney Dan, and thank you to all the mods. Dan's been very helpful today,
yes,
and
thank
is
you,
always
Dan.
So supportive. Really appreciate it, Dan. You have a great day, buddy. And check out this Chip and Dale one. So all of these are, or at least the three that are here, they are themed to attractions. So here's the teacups with Chip and Dale, and then you've got Tiki Room with Stitch, and then Mickey, of course, is on the railroad. That's awesome. JB Loves Disney coming in with a super chat. $3. Thanks for the stream. I was two when we were there. So I'm assuming you're talking about when you were at the 50th out in LA for the Star on the Walk of Fame. That's amazing. Thank you so much, JB, for that super chat. We really appreciate it. And thanks for joining us today. Everyone say thank you to JB. And so I really like this design, guys. I know we have looked at this in streams and vlogs, and they have this in a tree skirt too, but I just love this pattern.
I just realized Dumbo.
Oh, it's Dumbo, it's
Small World
and Haunted Mansion.
Okay, that's pretty awesome.
And Tiki Room, it's like everything. It's all attraction based. It's so cool.
Steph really
likes this design, guys.
I can't help it. It just looks so classic to me.
So all of those other stockings over there, including these, they're all $29.99. And they're big stockings. But they are $29.99. And out of all of the different plushes, guys, Pluto with the holiday sweater on has to be one of the best. It has to be one of the best out of all of the plushes. He just looks so awesome, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's very, very soft.
Yeah, he's really soft, and he just looks so comfy in his holiday sweater. Well, Chip and Dale are cool, too.
Yeah, they are.
There they are.
Oops, sorry.
Mexico, and they have some. Yeah, they're really neat, too.
He's adorable.
Cool. Well, that's neat, guys. So I don't see any more festival specific merchandise at this booth, but we're gonna go out here to the gift shops right as you get into the World Showcase, and we'll check out some of the merchandise in there. Yeah, Jennifer, that's exactly right. It looks just like the popcorn bucket, but in a plush form. So that's pretty neat. Yeah, everyone, welcome Dale to the stream. How you doing today, Dale? I take it you had a fantastic day yesterday at Dapper Day. I know that Dapper Day continues today, and we've seen multiple people here in Epcot. Continues over here into Epcot today, and I've seen multiple people dressed up. And if you don't know that it's Dapper Day, other people look at them like, why are they so dressed up like that? It's kind of funny. Oh, Plum, welcome to the stream. Just met you in the Coke store in Club Cool, and you subbed. Thanks so much. It was nice to meet you, and thank you for subbing. Hope you enjoy the content. Yeah, and the weather was good yesterday too, Dale, so you know that that obviously makes things a little bit nicer when you're wearing, clothes that aren't the coolest of clothes. Oh, Jen is at Magic Kingdom doing a vlog for Mickey's birthday. That's awesome. All right, so here is the Taste of the Three Kings booth, and we'll check out a couple of the items that they have here. I don't know about that.
See, I thought that one sounded good.
I don't like olives.
Exactly. It looks delicious, but then the flavor of olives will probably be too much that we wouldn't enjoy that.
Yeah.
Everything the rice here. Pudding.
Yeah. These queso fresco things look good. That's really, really cool. Yeah, here's the... And so, guys, I had seen this, and this looks really good. The tropical eggnog. So we'll definitely be trying this in the vlog.
Tropical eggnog.
It sounds delicious. So I think we're going to have to give that a try for sure. And then this tres leches rice pudding. Oh my goodness, that looks good too. All right, let's keep walking. Guys, it's getting warm out here. Welcome to the wintry warm Epcot. I think they're going to be opening up soon because I can smell the food being prepared. Yeah, actually, guys, during the Festival of the Holidays, I noticed there's quite a bit of gluten-free options. So definitely if you have a gluten allergy, the gluten-free options, there's they're plentiful here for the festival. I know I've gotten some lag in here before, guys, so let me get over here to where I think the merchandise is and we'll check it out. I don't. That's funny. Yeah, only... there's really no holiday or Christmas-specific merchandise for the festival in here. That's really interesting.
I'm really sad.
I know. Well, they, it looks like they have the bag behind the counter that you can get, you know, when you spend $40 or more, you can get it for $24. And it looks like maybe back here, let's see. No, nothing in here, guys. Really disappointing. Oh, actually, you know what they do have is the Chip and Dale map. Can I look at one of those maps, please? The Chip and Dale one? Thank you. So check it out, guys. This is the Christmas tree spree for Chip and Dale. So this is going around. This is the scavenger hunt for the Festival of the Holidays. And so you go around and you get all of these stickers and fill them on. And then I believe you bring this back and you get something for it. But that's pretty cool. Thank you very much. I did not pick up one of these yet. So here's the Festival of the Holidays
passport.
And yeah, guys, so we were talking earlier, December 30th is definitely the end of the festival. No, there is no, the festival center is not open for this festival, so that's kind of interesting. Oh, look at the train set, guys. I think this is the new one.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
look
so
at that. Stitches
so look,
in the window.
So here's the regular train set down here, you know, the smaller one. And this one is, I don't know what the price, what is the price of this one? Do you remember?
I think it's in the 139 range, isn't it? Oh, that's that.
Yeah, that's the Christmas one. And then look at this, guys. Look at the Christmas train. So there's the locomotive. So the front of the train, that looks really cool. And then the Holiday Express for the coal tender. And then there is the skating carol car. And that's pretty cool, too. You got Mickey and Minnie and Donald and Daisy. And then check this one out, guys. This is really cool. So you got Chip and Dale and Pluto and even Stitch poking his head. Stitch poking his head out of the train car. That's pretty cool. In the caboose. And then here's a box car. And it's got a, looks like a wireless remote control for start and stopping. And it looks like there's some audio too. But very cool. For $139 is this train set, and it's pretty big. I mean, that's the train itself is a pretty big train, so that's cool.
Yeah, it comes with 12 curved tracks and 10 straight tracks, so that I bet that does a pretty good size.
Yeah, and so I'm just gonna kind of glancing back through the passport here. So the ladies festival shirt, sorry, I'm just flipping through here looking for. So this festival is called the Festival of the Holidays. It used to be called, I believe, Holidays Around the World, if you guys remember that. And I know that in the past they continued to make Holidays Around the World shirts for the festival, even though it was no longer called Holidays Around the World. But I'm curious if they still have that. And I'm looking through here just to see quickly what merchandise they show in the book. To see if there's any... ooh, goodness, that looks good. Yeah, I don't see anything there. All right, let's go over and check this other one real quick. Across the way here, and then we'll look at more menus. All right, let's see if we have any better luck in here.
Well, at least seems like they have some holiday stuff.
Yeah, definitely a lot of Christmas ornaments in here. And there's that tree skirt.
Oh, wow. Let's show this off, because that's really neat.
Yeah, we saw this one before, and I was like, this is an awesome ornament. It is
it's
a $30 ornament,
yeah,
but look
beautiful.
How it's got all four parks in there. You got Epcot, Magic Kingdom, Hollywood Studios, and Animal Kingdom. Isn't that cool? That's a really, really nice ornament. And then over here, there's that print, guys, that we were talking about in the tree skirt.
Oh, that's so pretty.
So that's that same, the same stocking print in the tree skirt. And if I remember from Hollywood Studios, this thing is like, it's expensive for a tree skirt, I thought. Yeah, it's $70. So a $70 tree skirt, that is a little expensive. And then here again is just more of the Christmas merchandise.
Look at this.
Oh, it's a count, like a countdown calendar?
It's a countdown calendar with milk chocolate presents.
Mmm.
I know a little girl that would really like this.
Oh, check, I haven't seen these yet. The Christmas coasters.
Oh, those are pretty.
For $19.99.
Are they all wooden?
Yeah, they're all wooden coasters, and you can see. Oh, I wish they had them open.
Oh,
where
you could
see.
You could at least see
there's
the print
the design.
Style.
There's four different designs. The mistletoe one, the old So Merry, the magic of the season, and then the happy jolly Merry. And you can see they kind of have a they're kind of inset a little bit in the designs they're on them, and they're wooden. So it's a really cool set of coasters for $19.99.
You're cutting board again.
Oh, this is a lot bigger. This is like three times the size of the cutting board they gave out. This is a Merry Pright cutting board for $30, and this is a big piece of wood.
It's a tree topper. So you have Mickey with his little reindeer ears.
It looks like Mickey's wearing an earring.
No, it's like...
it's an antler ring.
Don't spoil it. No, I want to show you one more thing for you.
Guys, it's the Joe Rohde Mickey.
Check this out. It's the countdown for Christmas. This would look awesome sitting somewhere.
Yeah, you know what? I found this in a store.
Uh-huh.
In
I remember you talking about this
now. Guys, those of you who are in the stream when we were over at...
Here, I'll get them.
Ugh. When we were over at the Port Orleans Riverside, and we found this. Serrano, welcome to the stream. It was currently 52 days before Christmas when we were there, and we were trying to figure out how to make 52. So if you look at this
it's
one.
Not, it was 54.
It was 54?
Yeah.
So here we got 5, 3, 4, all the numbers we need. But here's the 5. Is there a 5 or a 4 on there?
There is no 5 and no 4.
So you couldn't do the 54 days. So it's like, I don't know how much this is supposed to count up to. That's the thing. But we couldn't do the 54 days like we wanted to.
You know what? I bet if you counted down from the beginning of December, you could.
Well, I'm sure you could do like 25. It must be the 25 days.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, you can see 25. So it must be that this is just to count
just
down from 25.
Month. Yeah.
But yeah, it needs it, that one more number, and then you could do a lot more. But they figured it out. Who's gonna put this up and count down from 52? I guess that's true. We just kind of were thrown off because Disney puts the stuff out so early. Now it's 37 days.
I was showing
you. Oh,
I made it snow.
That's pretty. Dashing through the snow. Mickey
they
and Minnie
happy.
On a reindeer. They do look happy. That's cool. Awesome. The happiest holidays. I don't see anything else in here, guys, that is like festival specific. Let's go check out over here real quick, because sometimes they have festival only merchandise. But I really don't see anything. Just really special in here. All right, so let's go check out some more menus and some of the booths heading over towards Mexico. Steph, I'm gonna go up this way. Are you done in here?
I found the style of stuff I like, and they even have... I love this. A little bit of wall decor. Yeah. So I love stuff that's like galvanized, kind of like that farmhouse look. It's really cool. And it's only $19.99. So cute.
That is really nice. Serrano, the weather is nice. It's actually starting to warm up. It was really nice this morning. Now it's starting to warm up. Only almost a little bit too much. Oh, here's another countdown, guys. A more kind of simplistic countdown. And here's some Christmas cards that are that same style that you really like with Mickey and Minnie stuff. And I think this probably, yes,
it's a light
is a
up candle. And it's,
can we light it up?
Well, I'll try.
Oh, oh yeah, the whole thing lights up. How cool is that?
Beautiful.
That looks really nice, guys. How much is that?
Let's see. $24.99.
It is pretty.
It is very pretty.
Let's shut it off so we don't kill the battery.
You hold.
You got it. So those are cool Christmas cards.
Oh,
and check it
cute.
Out, they got pillows too.
I know, those look awesome on the couch.
They got everything in this design.
I know, and you know I love it. Look, if you've got a baby at home, look how cute these are. Are you there?
And there's the Christmas wreath.
They're so cute. Well, that's cool too.
How much is that?
Stay still, 45.
Holy cow. So sometimes, guys, you just see something and you go, why is it that much? And here it is. It's not huge. It's just a stuffed ring with some felt leaves on it. And this is a $45 wreath. I don't think it's worth it. Definitely do not think it's worth it. All right, let's go check out some more booths, guys. Like I said, we'll probably end the stream here in just a short... Shortly, we're just going to come around here, check out a couple more of the booths around the World Showcase, and then Steph and I are going to kick off a vlog and start eating some food because I'm getting hungry. Oh, check it out. Here's some more Christmas stuff. Here is the festival shop, guys. I saw this and I wanted to come look at it. It looks like flannel, almost like...
pajamas?
Almost like pajamas, yeah.
And I like that design.
And here's the bottoms. You can see Mickey on them. Dale, you're becoming an enabler. That's awesome.
These are so stinking cute. Are you able to get a full shot of it?
Yeah, that is so cute.
These are like toddler style dresses.
It's
longer in the back than the front. That's adorable.
Yeah, that's really, really cute. Taylor and Lucy would look so cute in that. Look at the scarf. See, here's the Mickey scarf. Ooh, that's soft. How much is the Mickey scarf?
Free.
I found it first. $24.99. Here's the ears with the flannel bow. And then here are the Happiest Holidays hat ears, Christmas hat with ears. And that one's pretty cool too. And instead of having like the Christmas lights this year, they have the bells. These do have lights in them, but they also jingle. So they're really cool. That's awesome. I gotta check out that picture, Dale. I have not seen that yet.
That's so sweet, Dale.
Isn't that cool?
That's very nice.
Once again, Dale, you're making all the rest of us look bad. Me and Josh agree that you make us all look really bad. Wow, I can smell something that smells like fresh baked cookies. Can you smell that?
It smells really good, actually.
Oh man, that smells so good.
It smells like a bakery.
It does. It smells amazing. We're not. We're just going to go check out a couple more menus because we got to go all the way back to the beginning to start the stream.
amazing.
So it's getting busy back here now, guys. Getting closer to the opening of the festival. All the food booths getting ready to open. Smells, they're starting to smell delicious. Oh, Dale, you're making up for not going with her to the parks. There you go. Oh, check it out. That's cool.
What do you see?
Right here. So it's another festival shop, and I just saw a bunch of cards, and they're all like pop-up cards, and they look really cool. All right, guys, check this out.
They just opened.
Look at that. Guys, look at these Star Wars pop-up cards. How cool is that? Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Did you see that? All right, guys, ready? Look at this pop-up card. It's the X-Wing Starfighter, and this thing is $15. Ready? One, two, wham. How amazing is that? Look at that.
That's awesome.
I think it's a really cool card. I mean, you're not buying $15 cards for everyone on your list, but that is really, really neat. And over here is also an R2-D2 one that's pretty cool. I just really love the design of making these. It's so cool. And there's a bunch in here, guys. But yeah, look at the Beatles one. And this Nativity one's cool.
Look at the camel. That's awesome.
It is really neat.
Hi, welcome to the
vlog. Hi, how are you? Will do. These palm trees are really neat too.
And the way you write in it,
they look at this candle. Oh, so she was just showing Steph that.
Oh, very nice.
I can't do it. I'm gonna let Steph do it.
See that? They write on the arm.
Yeah. Yes.
Can you grab that one down there, the Christmas tree one?
Yep.
All right, Steph's gonna show this Christmas tree one. Look how cool that looks. And then show them, like she was just showing you, since this is all kind of like part of the artwork of the card, that when you write on it, there's a spot over here that you slide out, and that's where you write your message. Merry Christmas. That's so cool.
Very cool.
Yeah, they're really neat. Let me run down the line here and check out these other ones. Yeah, it is. It's very, very nice.
It keeps the art alive.
It does. And there's so many different designs here. And they're all very cool.
Yeah, they have something for everybody. Yeah, this is.
Look at this one, guys. Look at the Eiffel Tower. How cool is that? Wow. Look at how that like fills in. Look at that. Blown away. So cool. That's such a neat one. And look at the pirate ship, guys. Pirate ship. It's another little Christmas town.
This is just stuff they were allowed to bring.
That's awesome.
If you go on their Lovepuff's
website,
they should have a lot more.
So it's called Love Pops.
Yeah. It's probably lovepops.com. You'd have to ask them.
That's cool. Thank you so much. All right, guys. Those cards are really, really cool. I love stuff like that.
Now this is awesome. It's a light up wood sign that you can hang on the wall. It's got all the Mickey artwork on it and it's battery powered. That would look really
nice.
It
is really nice.
I really like that. I love how it kind of looks old fashioned.
Mm-hmm.
Very cute.
Oh, there's another festival specific merchandise. Oh, don't forget guys, those of you who aren't with us before, we're gonna give you another fair warning.
What do you have there?
The wood sign.
Here you go.
Here's another
warning to you guys who weren't with us before. If you want to buy this dish and use it for food, you can't because it's not for food use. And food consumed from this vessel could be dangerous and harmful. So definitely don't put food on this. And we saw this morning and I was like, what? Food on this could be harmful. Look, it's even on the bottom. It's like, this is a, it's a plate. I guess you put, like, you can put soap on it or something. It doesn't even say. But it does say that you don't want to eat food off of it or you might die, basically.
It's lovepops.com.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So that's, it's unbelievable.
Awesome. Good to know. Thank you.
So, fair warning. Probably want to stay away from these if you plan on trying to eat off of it. But look, some, we saw the apron earlier, and here is the tote in that same material for
$19.99. Oh,
danger plate. That's right, Ashley. Oh, yeah, check these out. So again, kind of going with that same theme, guys. I really like the theme. We've talked about it now a million times about this tree skirt. And check it out. They've got some ornaments that go along with it, too. So look at this tiki room ornament. How cool is that? I love the tiki room. I love Dumbo. And these are nice ceramic ornaments, too. But then you got Dumbo and then Toy Soldier down here. And then my favorite of all of these, and this thing is heavy. Check out the Small World ornament.
Oh yeah, it's really
heavy.
Isn't
it cool? How much are these?
Don't drop it. I'll look.
Don't drop the ornament.
$24.99.
$24.99. So these are expensive ornaments. I mean, if you want to get all four of them would be $100.
Right.
But they're so nice. They're just expensive, guys. But this one and the. This one and the Tiki Room one are amazing. Oh, man. I can't see.
I'm going to be by this Mexico thing, baby.
All right, well, let's go check out some more. Here's another menu over here.
Pete McDevitt, family brand new subs. Thanks for Spokes and RTV1 for suggesting. Well, welcome to the stream. We're happy to have you here.
Yeah, thanks for joining us. And thank you to Spokesman and Resort TV1 for the shout outs. We know that many of you came from the shout outs from their channels, and we really appreciate them. They've helped us out so much. Check out the enchilada.
That looks really
tamale.
Good.
The tamale looks good. Look at that. And then what is this? It's the
rice pudding with cranberries.
It's the arroz con leche, which is the rice pudding with cranberries. And that looks interesting and very, very festive.
Very festive. All
right, guys, we'll look at a couple more booths here, and then we're going to have to turn back because it's time to start a vlog. Food is available. Actually, the next booth is not till probably China.
Yeah.
So I don't want to get into
that
mess right now. Who's ready for another giveaway? I think it's time to give away another Mickey button. So those of you who may not have been here from the beginning, wasn't here for the other giveaway, we were talking about today is Mickey Mouse's 90th birthday. And in celebration of Mickey's 90th birthday, they're giving out buttons here in Epcot, and we gave away one button just a little while ago, and we're going to give away another button right now. And guys, we're going to start wrapping up the stream and start the vlogging here at the first day of the Festival of the Holidays. So many things we want to try, and it's starting to smell really good, and my stomach's starting to hurt, so we definitely want to... LDBC Dad says he can't stop thinking about the Chippendale Nutcrackers. Well, you just say the word, Craig. You need those Nutcrackers, and we can help out with that. They're big and heavy, but those Nutcrackers are really cool for sure. And here is Daisy doing her meet and greet for the Food and Wine Festival. Daisy had on her. had on her apron, and she was like Chef Daisy, but today she's just back to Daisy. All right, let's go over here, guys, to give away a button. Who's ready for a giveaway? Steph, are you ready?
I'm almost ready. I had something, but I'm not guaranteed an answer, so I want to make sure. But
Ashley, thank you so much for coming in. I really appreciate it, and I'm glad that you enjoyed the morning going around and having a good time here at Epcot. So thank you for joining. You have a great day. All right, guys, let's get right out. Look how pretty this is out here. It's a beautiful, beautiful morning here in Epcot. Looking across at the World Showcase. And then when we turn right here, we get this amazing Christmas tree. Get that shot right in the middle here. All right, guys. Steph, are you ready?
Yes, I am.
All right, well, let's show what we're giving away first.
Okay.
So we are gonna give away... Oh, look at that monorail shot, guys. With the monorail going behind the Christmas tree. That's awesome. All right, guys, so there you go. Let's get that in focus. There we go. That's a good screenshot right there, guys. Take that screenshot. Got the Christmas tree and Mickey. So, happy birthday, Mickey 2018. Today is Mickey's 90th birthday, so Steph is gonna ask a trivia question now. Guys, the first one of you to get that trivia question right, I will send you this button. Steph, go right ahead whenever you're ready.
Alrighty, in 1935, Mickey first appeared in color. What was the name of that film production?
Mickey's first colored film, guys. Go ahead and repeat the question, Steph, just to make sure everyone heard it.
In 1935, Mickey first appeared in color. What was the name of that film?
The answer's coming in. I see Fantasia, Red says.
I see a lot of friends going to Google.
Mickey's Dog Society, says Jessica. The Orchestra, Fantasia, Silly Symphony, DPC Dad, Craig. The Band Concert.
The Band Concert is the correct response from Jersey Baby Doll.
Jersey Baby Doll, the Band Concert. Congratulations. And now more are getting it. Jersey Baby Doll was the first one in with the Band Concert. That is so awesome. So Jersey Baby Doll, make sure to send us your information. Send me a private message on Instagram or on Facebook. Everyone can say congratulations to Jersey Baby Doll and send me your shipping information and we will get this out to you right away. And thank you so much. And yeah, such a beautiful day out here. Once again, happy 90th birthday to Mr. Mickey Mouse. It's been a great morning here checking out all of the merchandise that's available. Not as much as what you find in Food and Wine, but still quite a bit of merchandise available here. Let me flip you around. There we go. Yeah, quite a bit of merchandise. Not only just festival specific, but just Christmas merchandise. And we're officially starting to celebrate Christmas and the holidays here. I'm gonna flip around this way. I think we'll get better lighting. And we'll get the tree behind us. But it's been a great morning.
It has. It's starting to warm up and I'm certainly getting hungry.
Yes. And thank you guys so much for coming along with us today. It's been a lot of fun. And now we're gonna start vlogging. So our day isn't over, it's just starting. We're gonna start a vlog now. We're gonna go around and bring you guys around to show you all the food items, or not all of them, but at least a good amount of them today. And I have a feeling that a lot of them are gonna be sweet.
Yeah. So,
but it's gonna be fun. We're gonna have a good time. Hopefully Marshmallow Man's still here. I haven't heard from him. And we'll bring him along with us too. But guys, thank you so much. Thanks to all the mods for all your help in the stream today. All of you for coming along. And thank you so much for all the super chats and all your support. We really appreciate it. And we're going to go vlog now. So everyone stay safe. Have a great rest of your weekend. Enjoy this beautiful Sunday. Hopefully where you are, it's beautiful too. I know some of you are really cold right now. But I hope you enjoyed coming along with us because we enjoyed having you. So thank you very much for joining us and have a great day, everybody. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Thanks for coming.